Welcome to a lecture online. Now let's do an example about skid marks. It turns out that the faster car goes, when you jump on the brakes and you try to stop as fast as you can and you don't have anti-lock brakes on your car, then you'll leave long skid marks on the road. And the police can tell how fast you were going based upon the length of the skids. So let's say that some car tried to avoid an accident, jumps on the brakes, tries to stop as fast as they could, and they leave skid marks that are 120 feet long. How fast was the car driving in miles per hour? And so here's the equation that tells us that the distance is 1/10 v squared plus v, v of course being the velocity of the car. So how fast was the car going? Let's try to figure that out. So first we're going to write this as a quadratic equation with zero on one side. So we can say zero is equal to 1/10 v squared plus v minus the distance. And to get rid of that 1/10 in the front, I'm going to multiply everything by 10. So we get 0 equals v squared plus 10v minus 10d. And now let's plug in some numbers. For d, we have 120 feet. So 0 equals v squared plus 10v minus, equal to. So let's rewrite this here. So plus 10v minus 10 times 120, which is 1200. And now we have to solve this equation for v. And let's see here. That might actually be factorable, maybe. But if we're not sure, we can always use a quadratic formula. So let's try that. So we can say that v is equal to minus b, which is minus 10, plus or minus the square root of b squared, which is 10 squared minus 4 times a, which is 1, times c, which is minus 1200. And the whole thing divided by 2 times a. And a is 1. So let's see what kind of values we get for this. So v is equal to minus 10 plus or minus the square root of, that would be 4800 plus 10, that would be 4900. And the whole thing divided by 2. Now, the square root of 4,900 looks like it's 70. So that'd be minus 10 plus or minus 70 divided by 2. So we have two positive values. V is equal to, we have minus 10 plus 70, that's plus 60 divided by 2, that would be 30. Or V is equal to minus 10 is minus 80 divided by 2, which is minus 40. So we have two possible solutions for our velocity of the car. Now, one of them doesn't make a lot of sense. I don't think the car was going at negative 40 miles per hour. So that's not a reasonable answer. We can simply get rid of that. And so we can then say that velocity equals 30 seemed to make sense. That means the velocity of the car was 30 miles per hour, because we were told that the equation is 4 miles per hour if distance is given in feet. Even though we used the quadratic equation, because that always works, we could have actually factored it. And of course, with the answers, it was clear that this was probably factorable. So how do we do that? Well, we can say that this is going to be equal to the product of two binomials. And of course, for the first term, we get v and v. Then for the last term, we have a negative there. That means we have a positive and negative, because when you multiply a plus and a negative, you get a negative. And now we need two numbers. When you multiply, you get 1200, and when you add, you get a positive 10. That means the positive one is 10 larger than the negative one. And if we get rid of these two zeros for a moment, and we get rid of this zero, notice that 12 can be formed by multiplying 3 times 4, and 4 is 1 bigger than 3. So again, get rid of the zero, get rid of those two zeros. 3 times 4 is 12, 4 is 1 bigger than 3, so now you add one of the zeros, so you can say that 4v plus 40 and v minus 30 will work. And it will, because notice that when you multiply, you get negative 1200. When you add them, you get a positive 10. So then you could have said, okay, we know that v plus 40 equals 0, or v minus 30 equals 0, which meant that either v equals negative 40 or v equals plus 30. And again, the plus 30 makes sense, so that would be the answer. And that means that if you could factor it, it's a lot faster than using the quadratic formula, but either solution will work or either method will work. It'll give you the same solution. And that is how it's done.